We're at AT&T Stadium, the new Cowboys Stadium. What we're doing? Okay. All right. Here we go, baby. This is time for me to penetrate ladies through your panties. Woo! Heading down south to the land of the pines, thumbing my way back to North Carolina, staring at the road and pray to God I see headlines. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers, and in Raleigh I can see my baby tonight. Rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, in the wind, in the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Running from the cold up to New England, I was born to be a fiddler in the old-time string band. My baby plays guitar, I play the banjo now. North Country winters get me aging again. I lost my money playing poker, so I had to leave town. Ain't turning back to living that old life no more. Rock me, mama, like a wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the coast to the sea. Rock me, mama, go down on me. Hey, mama, finger me. I'll finger you too if you finger me also. We'll finger each other till the cows come home. Hey, I'm in Cowboy Stadium. I'm the halftime show in the Super Bowl. It's being played right here in Cowboy Stadium. Hey, let's go, Dallas. Walking the south out of Roanoke, I caught a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toque. But he was the west of the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. I gotta move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name. I know the only one, she died in Raleigh. I will die right now if I can't see her. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, anytime you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, finger me. Kayla Czar is in the house tonight. He's being fingered also, just like I am. Hey, mama, finger us. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, finger us. Mama, rock us down in the rain. Rock us in the snow. Hey, mama, finger us. Rock me, mama, till the cows come home. Rock me here at AT&T. Hey, mama, rock me. Kayla Czar, it's our 21st season. Are you ready?
I'm ready for it.
We're ready. It's Gorgeous George, and we are here. Kayla Czar, do we have some more music to crank?
Yes, let's play another song.
Let's do it.
Let's bring on the Dancing Girls.
Bring on the Solid Gold Dancers.
Yes.
on the back. Rock me, mama, till the cows come home. Rock me here in Texas.
All right, keep it going. Hey. Coming right up.
Rama, rock me. What are we doing there?
No, we're going to do a wonderful song next.
Well, I got to approve this now. It has to be especially approved.
How about Islands in the Stream?
How about no?
How about
Let Your Love Flow?
Okay, well, that's good.
Can we do that? I mean, unless you have a better one you put up there.
Yeah, if we had no idea tonight was going to be karaoke, but I guess that's what we're doing.
Well,
you know, had no idea here.
No, just keep talking. Oh, okay. Here we go. You want Let Your Love Flow?
I don't know. Is that the good version or what? Is it the real version? That's not it.
It's a good version.
That's not. The person's constipated. Kevin, did you do this yourself? It sounds like somebody's constipated. This is not the song. No, it's
here
not.
We go. Now let's start it.
Oh, now start.
That was just our theme song. All right. Everyone.
Yeah. There's a reason for the sunshine sky. There's a reason why I'm feeling so high. It must be the season. When the love light shines all around us. So let that feeling grab you deep down your crotch. And you're sending your love can, God. And then you go stealing and shake your load in your lover's face. Let your love flow like a mountain stream. And let your love grow with the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love bind you to all living things, and let your love shine, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season.
All right.
All right, what? There's a reason for the sunshine and sky, and there's a reason why I feel so high. Must be the season when the love light shines all around us. So let that feeling grab you deep in your groins and in your sin you're reeling, where your love can hide. Then you go stealing through the summer nights and drop alone your lover's face. Let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow with the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Let your love fly like a bird on the wing, and let your love bind you to all living things, and let your love shine. And you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Yeah! Let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow with smallest of dreams, and let your love show. And you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love bind you to all living things, and let your love shine, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season.
All right.
Let your love show, and you'll know what I mean, and let your love show, because it's
right.
The season.
Another song.
Same song? No.
No, not the same song.
The same song?
We got something. What else we
got here, Kev?
Oh, we got, let's do something fast.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the police study dot. Oh, my God. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, so proudly we hail by the star-spangled, yea, way.
And you say, "Nice."
Wait, Robert Goulet? You forgot the word?
Won't you promise me? Whoops. Why the John's early light? Whoops. Was that Carl Lewis that sang that? And
it was.
Yeah, Carl Lewis.
Carl Lewis was singing and he said, whoops.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Listen, Roseanne Barr, Jose Feliciano. The only person to acquit herself was Whitney Houston singing the Star Spangled Banner. If you get it wrong, you're going to get... Maybe, I don't know, if anyone's watching the show, I hope people were upset by that so they could protest and we might get on the front page of the paper.
That's right. It is Veterans Day. You should protest.
Happy Veterans Day, everybody, to our own veteran here.
How are you?
Mr. Vinnie Mac.
Yes. Oh, that's why you were all... Okay, that's what the deal was. I got you, because you got your hat, and so you served. I thought you served at the buffet, what you were talking about, served at the buffet. Yeah, that's what you said. You were it was fall season, you know, up here, and then I didn't know if you how many, you know, what was going on, if you, you know, how many twats you were taking care of over there.
Served.
You were served. Served. You were served, and did you serve?
I did serve, yes.
Yes.
And you were and you were serving the, you know, the twats.
Yes, served the buffet.
You served the buffet.
Okay. He's a fine veteran of the Navy. Our good friend. Vince. Okay.
And these two guys are veteran of the show.
We
just celebrate these two guys, my veterans. Veterans of the show.
Right.
So anyway,
so we were singing. I was singing. So we were in Cowboys Stadium, of course. So we're Cowboys Stadium. So they asked me to do the national anthem. Of course, then I forgot the words. And so then that was okay. So I ad-libbed like I always do and put some words down in there. So, you know.
It's Enrico Palazzo.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's right.
I can't believe.
Rico Palazzo.
Rico Suave? Rico Suave.
He'd be turning over in his grave if he heard that.
Okay. All right, so Kevin, usually you do your monologue at the very beginning, so we'll have you do your monologue right now while we're sitting here, and I'll tell you what I think about your monologue.
Okay.
Up and close. So tell me.
No, I was going to say simply wish all the veterans out
Thank
there
you.
The best.
Okay.
My dad is a veteran.
Yes, sir.
And he's and it's great. And let me tell you something. My dad's a great man. He's almost 90 years old. He's a World War II veteran, and he took on the Nazis and won. You know, when I was a kid, I didn't know. He said he was in the war, and I said, "Did you fight for the North or the South?"
No.
Anyway, we had a little trouble, of course, you know, with the trolls last year. And let me just give a warning to those chumps out there. My dad took on the Nazis. I was in reform school. On our worst day, we could handle the likes of your candy asses. So, so we have nothing to worry about.
I wasn't going
to
really even bring that up until you just did.
But let me just get back to saying that.
Going to bring that up. But no.
Yeah. Well, okay. What I'm trying to say is that our nation's military are the finest, and also let me make it very clear that, you know, a lot of these TV shows and AM radio make a big fuss. Well, if you're against the war in Iraq, or if you're against the Vietnam War, you're against the soldiers or something, against the sailors or something. Let me tell you something. If you want to be in favor of the military, keep them out of harm's way and not go to these awful wars in other countries. And, you know, there's all this talk. If you watch the Republican debates, they're making a big fuss about, let's start a war in Iraq again. Let's start a war in Iran. Let's go to Syria. All this stuff. And I like it that the idea that the ISIS and Iran, our hated enemy, are fighting each other. You know, when you have two enemies of yourself, when you know two enemies that are in a fist fight, you don't go in the middle to break them up. So I'm kind of glad that that's so. Like I said, let me just get back to what I was saying. If you really love the military and you really support the military as I do. And they do a great job.
I couldn't serve them.
Get them there. Stay them there.
I'm going to tell you
right
now, the drill sergeant would tell me. The drill sergeant would tell me, it's time to get up there, Private Yared. It's time to get out of bed. I said, you know what? Go finger yourself. I said, you know what? It's time for you to go like that up yours. You know, and of course, I'd be you know, thrown out. But like I said, I don't think I would have some guy tell me what I have to do in the middle. And when I'm telling him, he can go like this, you know. And you know, the drill sergeant tell me that I get up at the time I want to get up. That's why being self-employed and being able to do what you want to do and the time you want to do, make your own deal, is the way to go. Yeah. Mucho dineros, being self-employed, and that way you're not in jeopardy of getting fired or getting fired by somebody that doesn't like you.
Yeah. Well, okay. That's good.
That's the way that's
nice
what it boils down to.
Get it. Yeah.
You know.
You know, in fact, we were talking a few years ago, you know, we do this wonderful show together, and I was wondering if we should do a sitcom together.
Do a sitcom.
Yeah, I mean, like, we could bring back Gomer Pyle. I think you'd make a wonderful Gomer Pyle, George. a straight Gomer Pyle this time.
Yeah. Golly, Kevin, I had no idea what was going on there.
But I think it would be great. I mean, instead of being Gomer Pyle, the dumb guy, you would be Gomer. You would be the Gomer Pyle. Don't tell me I have to wake up early in the morning. I mean, you just sort of it sort of writes itself.
That's right.
I could play Sergeant Carter. Get the.
All right. Last week we were talking about some things that were very interesting. We're going to retouch on them, and you know, and talking about basically if gays have a right to be married. Then maybe you have a right to make love to your pet giraffe. Maybe bestiality should be legal too. I mean, let's face it. If you want to fuck,
what?
If you want to screw your light, I know. If you want to screw a light bulb, and I don't mean you know screw it with your fingers on top, but if you want to screw it, if you want to screw a monkey, then by all means, you know. So basically, in essence, what we're talking about is. And we were talking about this before, and we were touching about this again because the last week's show, by the way, never got recorded. Last week's show never got recorded, so we're going to retouch upon some things.
We're going to do a rerun. We're going to do a brand new rerun. Is tonight a rerun?
Yeah, tonight is going to be a rerun. So, like I said, so, you know, in the military, I mean, like I said, yeah. You know, they say, and, you know, just people in the military, gays in the military and whatnot. Mm-hmm. So they serve the military. So, well. You know, gays, you know, want, you know, now or it's now considered to be a marriage. It still can be a marriage, but it's as far as I'm concerned, it's all it is a union. So, well, let's take it from the next decor. If a man wants to get, a man wants to marry maybe a cow before he eats it, or maybe you know, maybe this woman wants to marry this monkey, and you know, having a nice penetration, a nice anal sex, you know, whatnot. So yeah, I mean, what's the difference? I mean, because we can talk about this till the cows come home. I mean, you know, humans and animals.
No.
Humans and animals. You know, so yeah.
Humans.
But it'll be looked at in the same regard. The same regard. No. Looked at the same breath.
It's not consensual. Humans and animals. Mm.
Two. Maybe. How do you know that?
I'll be honest with you, I don't know that.
Okay.
You seem to be more of the authority.
No.
How come guys who are always against gay marriage always bring up animals? I mean, what? Do they know something we...
you don't know. Can you think for that animal?
I mean,
have you done an animal?
Mike Huckabee is always at Chick-fil-A. He knows chickens better than he knows.
Here we go again by building up and bringing up somebody that has nothing to do with what I'm talking about.
No, he has everything because
he's the CCP. I'm not even talking about religion. I'm talking about something, you know, now we're the minority. We are the minority I'm the belief system. Upon, you know, it being a union, now it's considered to be a marriage. I will never get that.
Let me tell you.
It's considered to be a union, and now it's considered to be a marriage because, you know, the Supreme Court put their hands involved in there. And, you know, the states had the rights to make the call there. The states had the rights to make the call. So still, as far as I'm concerned, it's a union. And you can tell, I mean, we can talk about this if the cows come home. So.
Well,
that's my belief. That's the way I feel.
So. Well, actually, I think touching back on what we earlier said, a white male, straight Christian is never in the minority. You are still on the top of the heap right now.
I don't know about that. Because, I mean, I don't know. You know, I don't know about that. Still, I don't know about that per se, if that is true.
There's not a whole... How many non-white Christian males are running for president right now?
Me, I'm running.
There's Hillary.
Well, you're
there's
a
Bernie.
Aren't you a Christian?
And there's Ben Carson and then Carla Fiorina. They're the only non-white Christian males.
And that caller, Reverend Nina from Hewlett Packard, she has a bull face, and Donald Trump is right about her. She looks like a bulldog. But go ahead.
Well, okay, getting back to Carla. Carla,
her friend Ronnie has no chance, zero chance of winning. She has a bulldog face.
Smart woman.
And she has equivalency. She has the intelligence as my testicles do. Go ahead.
Carla is is a very brilliant CEO, and then she kind of brought Hewlett Packard to the ground and got fired, and then
hence,
she ran for
bringing
governor
Hewlett Packard, bringing that down.
And now
and she'll bring this and she'll bring this country down. We already know that there's one woman who is going to be the next president of the United States, and it ain't going to be Sarah Palin, ain't going to be Carla, or ain't going to be Carla or Sarah Palin. It's going to be Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton should have won it in 08. She's going to win it in 16. She should have won it in 08. She's going to win it in 16, and this country is going to be back on track with the Clintons back in control. That's
not
all I got to say.
Not happy with Barack?
Well, Barack is fine. But I mean, but you know, the Clintons were, Barack was great, but he's no Bill Clinton. It's obvious.
Barack ain't no Bill Clinton.
He ain't no. There ain't gonna no comparison.
He's better.
No one's
better than Bill Clinton.
No. Not even.
Bill, I mean, I remember we saw Bill when he came in 2008,
right.
Running for promoting Barack. He was at VCU, and I mean, it was almost like a movie star coming down. Hey, everyone to go backstage. Can I see Bill?
No.
I shook his hand when he was governor when he came years ago for the debate.
Right.
But that was he was governor. I didn't get anywhere close to him when he came back as a former president.
So, the Clintons need to be back in office, and I'm all for the Clintons and Hillary to be back in office and have her as the president. Have the president of the United States, basically.
She might even be better than Bill. You never know.
I don't know. But I think she's the candidate.
Yeah.
She's the candidate, and she is the person, as far as I'm concerned, to be the next president. She's going to be the next president of the United States. I like the drama that Trump presents. I like drama's energy and his arrogance. That's why I think it would be interesting to have Trump in there. People say, are you a Trump supporter? You're taking up for Trump. No, I like Trump. I like Trump's arrogance, and I want him to be the Republican nominee so Hillary can wipe the floor with him.
Trump.
I want Trump in there so Hillary can wipe the floor with him and basically have her way. And then, you know, maybe if Trump plays his cards right, maybe she'll get up in his cabinet.
You know, I really
get him in her cabinet.
But I'm not sure about Trump being president. I really don't want the grown-up Biff from Back to the Future as president.
No.
Wasn't that in the movie?
That's right.
Was the president?
That's right.
Yeah, he was just like
so
Trump.
Anyway, you know, and like I said last week, you know, I have decided, because I'm tired of all this bull malarkey, I am running for president of these United States. I am running for president of these United States, and I haven't chosen who my VP is going to be. So you two best butter me up. You two best butter me up. You best be on my good side, because it's going to be a hard pick. But one of you two will be my VP.
You seen Last Tango in Paris? Go get the butter. Go get the butter right now.
Yes.
If that's what you're
in. That's right. Get the butter?
Get the butter.
What kind of butter?
Go get the Land O'Lakes.
The Land O'Lakes? You know, people make their own butter, too.
Butter.
They churn their own butter.
Yeah.
You know, like this, you know?
You
like
don't
this?
Want that butter.
Like this?
You
don't like
want
that? Like
no.
Oh, Miss Daisy! Whoa, Miss Daisy! I'm churning the butter for you, baby!
Are you milking
I'm
like
churning
that?
The butter for you, baby. Anyway, so this is pretty much how it goes down. But like I said, if you want to have sex with your giraffe, if you want to have sex with an orangutan, you have sex with a monkey and all that, with Gigi as president, you'll be able to do that.
Oh, that's wonderful.
You'll be able to have sex with your monkey, have sex with an orangutan, have sex with anything you want to have sex with.
Now, the one thing...
You'll be able to do that under my term. You'll be able to have sex with whoever you want to have sex with.
Wow.
Because now... We're putting making a fair ground here.
Even
playing field right now.
Even playing field for everybody.
So there you go.
I want to see the first union between farmer and cow. Because I guarantee you, McDonald's, Burger King, Wendy's, Taco Bell, they are not going to be very happy with that.
Right.
Because
and PETA isn't going to be happy with that neither, but that's beside the
point. Yeah, PETA's
not going to be happy with that neither, but then, of course, then they're going to have to say, well, you know, you want love for your animals, right? So this is going to show you some true love. So tell PETA, look, relax. Just relax, because we're going to show you some real love to these animals in ways you never can imagine.
Gosh, it's like President...
Real love like you never can imagine.
This is like President Caligula.
Caesar! Caesar! Don't, Caesar! No, no!
Can't believe you're not married.
And Kevin, and I can believe that you aren't. Because now you talk about basically that.
Yeah.
That you're looking now for a marriage, and I don't see that. I mean, here you are, man. I mean, now in this in your twilight years, and you're ready for marriage.
Maybe you sound like the guy that was found in the iceberg.
Well, I mean, you know, the glacier. I don't know. I mean, so you're saying that basically that you're ready now? You're ready now for a marriage, ladies out there. He's giving you an invite right here, Kevin. Sell yourself to the public and tell them what you're ready for.
Ready to get married. Ready to have children.
Okay.
Ready to be.
So you're ready to be the president of the Punani Nation.
No, not just in a more humble way.
What's the more humble way about it? You want to be president of one's nice Punani Nation.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
You know who I'm talking about. Which one out there are you trying to? Is it one per se, one person, or is it a? You want a bunch of votes.
It's all a journey. It's all a voyage.
Okay.
I mean, so then, as many women.
So then there you go.
For the job.
Makes my point. So you're not ready to settle down.
Wait a minute.
You have a bunch of women out there that you're still trying to fill your wild oats with.
You could.
You have a bunch of women that you're still trying to fill your wild oats. So you're not per se looking at one woman, you're looking at a whole bunch.
Well,
of them.
You make it sound like I'm supposed to pick the one woman and then marry her.
It's
not that. You have to.
What happened to Mrs. Lazar?
In my case, it's a lot. Oh, Mrs. Lazar.
What happened to her?
She's no longer, unfortunately.
What happened to Mrs. Lazar? Did she?
Well, she. I don't know what happened to her. She was on this weight loss plan, where she took these pills.
Okay.
To lose 2 pounds a day, and after 150 days, she completely vanished.
Okay, it's like a puff and smoke. Puff and smoke.
Poof.
Puff.
But seriously, it's been a lifetime. I feel I've done everything in my life, and that's something that what I would love to do next. Yeah.
What you would love to do next.
Yeah.
But you would know that if you would do that.
Well, you would want to do that, too. And I'm
I don't know what I want, Kevin, because, you know, I want my cake and eat it, too. I want it all. I want the works, because I deserve the works. But we're not talking about me. We're talking about you.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying. So, you know, but, yeah. So, you know when you're in this, really, you know, when
you
you're
this. You know when you're in it.
You know, right. But then
you know
you,
when,
but
and you certainly
still,
know when you're not in it.
Hold on.
Yeah.
You say that you know, but we know you. You're going to want. Do you want to have more? I mean, even being in that relationship or being in that so-called marriage, you're going to have tendencies to see other women, and you're going to crave those other women.
Not if you're truly in love with your wife or girlfriend, a steady girlfriend or something.
Well, what's happened?
You don't look at other women. Believe it or not, I've been in relationships.
What's happened through all these years where you wanted to field your oats, and you couldn't just be with one. You wanted more.
Well, if you want to be with others, then you shouldn't be with that one.
Well, I'm just saying.
I know that you
can't be with just one. You said you were ready for one, but I know in the past you just couldn't be with one. You had to have your hair washed every single day with a different woman.
Yeah.
So now, what's going to change that?
Until then, I'd like my hair washed every day by a different woman. But now, I would like to find the one woman to wash my hair every day.
And you would be able to be content with that one woman.
You'd
be content with that one woman and not be able and not feel like you got to play everything.
Well, I'm 41 years old now, and I can't.
41. 41.
I'm only 41 year old with a colostomy.
And so you've been 41 for about the past how many years?
20 years.
20 years.
You've been 41 for the past 20. Okay.
20 years.
Yeah. I rest my case.
41 and holding.
I rest my case on that. Anyway.
They just simply have women line up at this door here. Come on down to the gorgeous
show. Actually, I should tell people my real age, which is actually 67 years old.
Now
don't I look good for 67? I look terrible for 41. But for 67, I look wonderful.
Kevin, I tell you what, you amaze me. You absolutely amaze me sometimes. Man. The things that come out of your mouth, the things that come out of your mouth, is the darnest thing what kids say,
yeah.
And it's the darnest thing what Kay Lazar says out of his mouth.
I should have been on the Art Linkletter show when I was a kid.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know, let me tell you something. I'm from Hopewell, Virginia, and I always wanted to be on the Art Linkletter show, and you know, they said kids said the damnedest things. Yeah. Someone told me that they weren't sending limousines from California to Hopewell, Virginia to pick me up. But I would have wiped the floor with those kids. You want to see comedy? I was the funniest 6-7-year-old you've ever met. I'm still pretty funny. So. Okay.
So, I mean, is there like a doll where they pull the string and you say shit?
I say all the stuff.
No, I mean, you pull the string and you say stuff. Like
a say it.
Hey, hey, pal. Finger me, pal.
I don't say that.
Hey, finger me, pal.
Don't put words in my mouth.
Well, I'm just saying. So you pull,
don't put words in
you
my
pull
mouth.
The string and it says the darndest things.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, I let me tell you, I was on all the kids shows growing up. I was on the Dandy Beagle and Superdog show. I was on the Sailor Bob show.
Sailor Bob.
I was on the Bozo and Superdog show. Mm. I was on all the Superdog shows. Bozo, I was on, yeah, remember Bozo? And I was on, and now I'm on this show. And I've been on, I was once interviewed by Frank Soden in the middle of a hockey game in the 1970s. Mm-hmm. And I've been all over.
You've been all over the world.
Yeah.
Okay.
And what else could I tell you? But anyway, after all that, I told my dad, I said, I want to be on all the shows now. I want to be on all the kids' shows. I want to be on Captain Kangaroo. And he said, yep. You ever see kids on Captain Kangaroo? And that show is not in Richmond. They do that show in New York. We're not going to send you all the way to New York to appear on the Captain Kangaroo show. No. Mr. Rogers. No, I mean, Mr. Rogers' show was in Pittsburgh. You ever saw kids on that show?
Okay.
So that guy was kind of weird anyway.
And Fenty Island was in some island far away, yeah. You know?
This well, that is, was a, you know, more of a
some Fenty Island.
I never really saw that as a kid show, but Mr. Rogers.
No, that was a kid show.
But Mr. Rogers, I mean, no, what's the deal with Mr. Rogers?
No, Fenty Island was a kid show because they had the little, you know, had Mr. You know, the little midget there, yeah. Tattoo.
How's that too?
I'm tattooed. This is the plane. Yeah. You know, he was a midget. You know.
Yeah.
And I've always said everybody should have a pet midget.
Yeah.
You have your pet dog. You have your pet cow. Mm-hmm. Or I mean, your pet cat. Wow. Pet dog. Everybody should have a pet midget.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, you know? Call them children.
Yeah.
So
I'm just saying. So
they get bigger though.
So in Fantasy Island, you know, that was a kid show.
Yeah. Okay.
Fantasy Island was a kid show. Every desire was fed.
I remember an old episode of the Gorgeous George Show. You once imitated Mr. Rogers. You remember that? And it's a beautiful day in the
neighborhood. Yeah, yeah.
You were like a perverted Mr. Rogers, which is actually kind of redundant because I thought the real Mr. Rogers was kind of perverted. I mean, what's the deal with that? Is he obsessive compulsory? We had to take off his shoes and put a change him.
Let's channel this here. Let's try to channel this. Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to Gigi's Neighborhood. How you doing? Don't tell your parents anything about this now. I want you to go ahead and come over here and play with Mr. Rogers. Play with Gigi. Don't tell your parents anything about this because they don't need to know. Hey, Sue Ellen, come over here and play with Mr. Rogers. Play with his face and rub his face. Yes, that's a good girl. Now let's teach you a little. Children, I want to teach you a word. And I want you to understand this word. Listen very carefully. Bitch. Bitch. Yes. That's what some of these women out there are that don't like Gorgeous George. Oh. Say it with me. Bitch. They don't like Gorgeous George. That's what you call them.
Wow.
Hey, boys and girls, I got another two words for you. Come over here with a close-up. Boys and girls, right here with a close-up over here. I got another word for you. And then the other word here with a close-up is finger me. I finger you, you finger me, we finger each other. Yes, boys and girls, these are nice words to say to the adults. Welcome to my neighborhood. Would you be my, won't you be my, won't you be my neighbor?
Well, that's right. That's a real land of make-believe.
Wow, yeah. It sure is. I can tell Mr. Rogers is rolling over in his grave right now.
Yeah, well, you know.
I once saw Mr. Rogers. He wasn't very nice to me. He said, that's Mr. Rogers to you, and get the hell out of my neighborhood.
That's right. The way it is. Listen, I don't know. I mean, you know, you remember in kindergarten when you had your placemats?
Oh, yeah.
You go back in kids, and you had to bring your placemats. Yeah. And when it was time to go sleep, mm-hmm. you get your placemats. Now, children, we need you to get your placemats. Don't space them out now. Lay down and be quiet now for 30 minutes so I can get my thoughts together, kids. Get your placemat. Don't say a word. Just lay down on your placemats, and this is going to be some relaxation time, some quiet time. Be quiet for 30 minutes so I can sit here and get some real quiet time for myself. Okay, you remember that?
I remember that, and yes. I remember in first grade we were all talking, and we were all misbehaving, and the nun came in and was so mad at us, and she was actually supposed to give us a nap time. She goes, listen, I don't want to give you a nap time, but the principal says I have to give you one, so we're going to try to punish you and have your nap time at the same time. So everyone's like, oh, what's going on? So she said, okay, you're all going to get in your cots and take your naps, but you will not be allowed to get your pillow and turn it over to the cool side if it gets too hot.
Oh.
And like all these little girls, you know, they were always hot. And they said, oh, come on. And I didn't really care, you know. So what? As long as I lie down, you know. People were always yelling at me when I was a kid. So anyway, this one girl just started crying and bawling. And she goes, oh, I want to turn it over to the cool side of the pillow. And she said, the nun said the funniest thing I think I've ever heard. She said, mm-hmm. Our Lord wore a crown of thorns. You can stand the warm side of the pillow.
That's right.
Elementary school, punishment was bad, especially at my elementary school when I was mm-hmm. in Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
This was the second grade. Okay. Now, the thing is, during lunchtime, if we were good, okay, we could sit down in front of the TV and watch the Bozo Show.
Oh,
the Bozo Show.
Because, you know, the man.
There's a big show in Chicago.
Bozo.
Yeah,
big show the in Bozo. Chicago. Yeah. Now, if we were bad, then the teachers put us in front of the TV and make us watch a Chicago Cubs game.
Oh, man.
All the kids.
Ernie Banks might win.
All the kids in their cots in elementary school should be watching the Gorgeous George Show. Because not only do they get an education, they get a education. All these kids out there will be taught a thing or two in their placemats in kindergarten. If they watch the Gorgeous George Show, they'll be getting an education. And that ought to be a curriculum in schools. And all these little private schools and these grammar schools, that ought to be the curriculum right there. Be watching the Gorgeous George Show. And watch the Gorgeous George Show and record it and play it so you all can, you know. You all can feel the energy. Feel the energy.
I hope you learn something from me.
And learn something, you know, the words that come out of my mouth, and learn the adult words, and learn the adult entertainment, and learn how to please yourself when you see the Italian Stallion on your screen. Because, you know, the ladies out there that watch me, they pleasure themselves to every word that I say by watching every move that I make. They pleasure themselves down by strumming their little organ in the bottom. They strum it very good and play the organ very well for Gigi. This show should be on pretty much every hour.
Yeah, I have to admit that if I were a little boy, this would be the type of show I'd beg my mom to let me watch. And she would say, no, you're going to have to watch Billy Graham or something. And he goes, no, then I would secretly try to watch this on the fly.
Right, watch on the fly, basically.
A great educational show for elementary school.
Yeah.
Especially in the first grade. You know.
Hey, kids. Biatch. Count. 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 Biatch. Bastard. Say it with me. Bastard.
Yeah, I'll
finger. Finger you, me. Finger you. Say that.
What?
I definitely would have trouble in Chicago if this show was on in the first grade.
Well, actually, that's a good idea. We should try to branch out and maybe do a show for children.
Yeah.
And I mean, it wouldn't be the show we'd do late at night,
yeah,
but I mean, we would have toy commercials.
It would be.
candy commercials.
Yeah.
I see us doing a show that would just be fun for kids, not any educational, so we wouldn't make them eat their vegetables or something.
Well, that's right. Everything we do is educational, Kevin. Everything we come up with is educational. What we do on this show is educational. It's educational for all ages, what we do. Yeah. No discrimination. What we do is educational for all ages.
Yeah.
I'm saying if...
It's fun for the whole family.
If Bruce or Crystal Jenner, whatever her name is, want to have sex with RuPaul or Dennis Rodman, okay, well then I guess now they can do that. They can rub dongs together. Well, now if so and so wants to have sex with a giraffe, then they should be able to do that. No discrimination here. That's all I'm saying.
I would surely hate to see the kids come out of Caitlyn Jenner on that situation.
I don't know. If Caitlyn Jenner and RuPaul or Caitlyn Jenner and Dennis Rodman want to rub dongs together, I guess now they can do that. But now, no discrimination here. Mm-hmm. I mean, if Roy Fontelot wants to have sex with an elephant, then he should be able to do that. Or if maybe if Mini-Me, Vern Troyer, wants to have sex with an orangutan, he can do that. Or maybe if a woman wants to have sex with her horse, she should be able to do that. Yeah. If you want to have sex with your monkey, then you should be able to do that too.
Wait a minute, isn't Mini-Me dead?
No, Vern Troyer?
He's still alive.
No, he's still alive.
I thought he was dead.
No, Vern Troyer is still alive.
Well, read the internet.
Very much alive.
The internet proves that everyone's still alive.
The internet proves everything.
Yeah.
Each one of us have a midget. Kevin's got a little midget running around. Vince, I don't think you. I think yours is. Do you have a midget running around, Vince?
I do have a midget running around, but he went to wrestling.
Okay, but Kevin definitely has a midget of himself running around, and believe it or not, I have a little GG running around too. I have a little GG running around also too. So that, you know, these are people that are, you know,
midget wrestling.
No, so yeah, well, yeah, this is on hold. So that pretty much how that plays out there.
Now, I think we would do a very good show. We could have a game. We have guests. We could have a show like Mr. Rogers, the land of make believe puppets. I see learning the alphabet like on Sesame Street.
Yeah, but I
a giant bird causing trouble.
George will learn the alphabet backwards.
Yeah, every time I get stopped by the police, I have to rely on the alphabet going backwards. Yeah.
All right, so I don't know what to see. Basically, when you are in a monogamous relationship, relationship, and you're it's uno, 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 and mano, mano, and you're being productive, and you're, you know, it's your degree right now, basically, that, you know, if that individual, I guess, can't accept you for who you are.
Right.
Then I guess, you know, whatever. Because the way I see it in my world, that if, you know, they can't accept you, then they should be able to,
of course,
they should be able to, you know, go south. But like I said, right. but she's still... If there's the feelings that are there, you still try to sell yourself and try to promote yourself to be what you are, who you are.
That's
you know, good, and you try good, to give who be the best person, because no matter how down it might be, no matter how down you get, bottom line is when I look in the mirror, I said, you know what, damn it, you're Gorgeous George, and they aren't. You're Gorgeous George. You're the rock star 24/7, and they aren't. So guess what? They aren't. I am. And you know what? It takes a lot of time. So you all can just be, you know, you want to critique what we do, critique everything. Just sit down there and watch and hold on to everything that we say. And get your number two scribble, your Sharpie out. Get your number two Sharpie or whatever, number four Sharpie, and take notes, you know, because this is very educational. It's a very educational learning experience. And we also, and for the blind too, for the we have Braille for the blind, and for the hearing impaired, we do this. For the hearing impaired, we do this.
Yeah.
And like that. So anyway.
The universal language.
That's right, universal.
You know,
for many.
Actually, you're not. I mean, you're a very funny man, George. But you are not, you're actually telling the truth. You should be the best person you can be, and not a second place version of somebody else. Meaning, I know so many women who have told me, Why can't you wear like knit shirts and cargo shorts like all my other boyfriends did? Or my other boyfriend didn't drive a car like you do. I said, well, I'm not going to do
it. Is that person still on one or on two? They're gone.
That's fine. And you should do things your way. And if they don't like it, there's a whole line of girls behind them.
All right, we don't normally take calls, and we're not going to take calls. But if you all wait long enough, I will feel like basically then pick up the phone when I'm ready to do so. So if you wait long enough, that means that you're listening and watching. Yeah. And then I would be able to pick up the phone. But that's really, we don't take calls at this number. But no. What I'm saying is, but then you know, if you're in that relationship, you still try to make it work. If you're in that relationship. You're still committed. You still try to. You want to make it work no matter what. And then even if you get, you know, things happen, you still try to forgive and you still try to push and push and push. You know, you do what you got to do, and that's what it boils down to. But nothing is easy. Nothing worth having is easy.
No.
One thing you can say that, you know, basically. Yeah. But like I said, but with me as your president, if you want to have sex with your midget, or if you want to have sex with your orangutan, you can do so.
You know what? Having the sex with an orangutan.
I don't eat Cracker Jack, Kevin. And the Cracker Jack you find on the Lee Art. Remember the Lee Art Theater?
Yeah, I remember that.
Or in the theater, you know.
That was
Miss Minnesota walks the stage. The stage like that, and then all of a sudden, the spotlight comes on, and you see this old man going, you know, jerking off. No! Don't leave me! Don't leave! No.
Actually, at the Lee Art Theater, this wasn't the only thing stuck to the floor.
Well, it was a Cracker Jack. That stuff was big time.
I once met Vanessa Del Rio at the
theater. But like I said, once again, if these people can have, you know, call this marriages, all these people can call this marriages, basically, then you should be able to call a union or a marriage to make it out with your significant other, and whether that be an animal, or you know, your giraffe, horse, or kangaroo, or a orangutan, or monkey, then call that a union and call that a marriage also.
That would be one hard show to see.
And I'll tell you what. Those monkeys don't take any shit.
Yes, right.
Those monkeys will maul your face.
Yes, they will.
They'll maul your face. They're strong as five men. They're as powerful as five men. They put their hand on your head and they'll demaul your face.
Yes.
In fact, it was talking.
And then they'll take their feces and they'll throw it at you. The feces in rapid speed, throw it in the edge. You go,
which brings me, actually, a few years ago, you were trying to get a chimp on the show.
Yeah, I was, wasn't
and, I? And this was in the wake of that, what he's talking about.
Yeah.
And I said, if a chimp comes on this stage, I'm getting the hell off the stage. I don't want to be covered in feces or have my face torn off just for a show. And or.
Kevin, you got to pony up. Kevin, you got to pony up. You got to take it on for the team. You got to take it for the team.
Not that.
That's all I got.
Anyway, to show you my gratitude, George, you could have my surprise from the Cracker Jack.
What's the surprise?
I don't know. They opened it.
Surprise.
It's a little present for you.
Yeah.
Surprise and son? Okay.
There's always a prize in the Cracker Jack.
Is it a surprise?
These used to be rings. These used to be rings and silly putty. Now they're junk.
It was a beautiful woman.
The emblem for the St. Louis Cardinals.
Oh, then you should keep that. That's your
baseball.
Your team, yeah.
In baseball,
I didn't know that. It just happened to be
baseball. The emblem for the St. Louis Cardinals here in baseball. That's my team in baseball. Yes.
You could have that, like rub it on your skin.
No,
fake tattoo, and then they could actually make a real tattoo from that.
I could put it on my balls as a tattoo.
I could
put it on my balls on a tattoo of the cardinal in my balls.
Well,
I put the cardinal in my balls, in a ASAC.
Who's gonna see it?
Yeah.
That significant other will see it. Whoever that lucky significant other is, she'll see it.
Oh, okay.
Now, what happens if she's a Cubs fan? I know she ain't going to be happy.
Yeah, that might be it.
Well, as long as it's penetrating in her, she'll be liking it anyway.
She might be a Kansas City Royal fan.
As long as she's being drilled and it's penetrating, she'll be happy enough to be excited to see it anyway.
And not happy to see anything having to do with the Cardinals. Mm-hmm. You know, like I know a lot of pretty girls that are Patriots fans, and I'm a Giants fan.
I cannot
bring up the fact when it gets down to business that I'm a Giants fan. I tell her that after it all goes down.
Well, of course, we're talking football. Of course, we're taking a.
I can't believe I slept with a Giants fan.
Yeah, we're taking a moratorium on. We're not talking football right now.
Why not?
No, we're not talking football right now.
I know why. because
no, we're not talking football right now.
His team's in the cellar.
Yeah, okay. Well, you know what? That's fine.
Yeah. And I've been waiting a long time for this too.
Yeah. Well, it's not over yet.
But you're right. It's not over.
It's not over yet.
It's still 9 weeks.
Redskins are. I will have to admit
that I, believe it or not, betted on the Cowboys last week.
Yeah, I wanted the Cowboys
to
win.
But then again, that's the reason why the Cowboys lost.
Yeah. Oh, I can't friggin' stand the Eagles.
Listen. I'm going to say this, and I'm not worried. It's a marathon, not a sprint. Right now, we're in the cellar, but the way I see it to be is that anything can happen.
That's true.
Romo should be back, I'm hearing, as early as next week. I'm hearing Carolina, but I'm hearing Romo will probably be back not this week. Mm-hmm. Romo will be back next week. And I don't have the list in front of me to know who we're playing. This year has been a joke. It's been a joke, basically. But it just goes to show you first to last, last to first. First to last, mm-hmm. last to first. Not worried about it. Only one team is coming out of that division, and it's not going to be the Giants, and it's not going to be the Eagles, and it's not going to be the Foreskins. So that
I think
us.
It'll be Washington.
It's going to be. It's not going to be the Eagles. It's not going to be the Giants. It's not going to be the Foreskins. It's going to be the Cowboys. The Cowboys will find a way to win that division once Romo comes back. We're going to beat the Buccaneers this week. We'll beat the Buccaneers this week. Then the week after that, I don't even know what the schedule is. I have to dig it up. If Romo comes back next week and we start pulling wins off, we'll be fine. We've got the Jets, the Dolphins, and the Bills. All beatable game. Jets, Buffalo, Bills, and the Dolphins. All three winnable games, as far as I'm concerned. And then we have the Foreskins. Foreskins twice, winnable games. Two guaranteed wins. Two guaranteed wins right there. So, you know, we'll win the rest of our games. The only game that worries me are the Packers. But, you know, we'll get the Packers for retribution for last year. Packers worry me a little bit, but we'll get the Packers back for retribution, so we'll win the rest of our games, and we'll be fine.
Yeah. When the Redskins and the Cowboys play, I hope they both lose.
That's what I was saying about last week's game.
These games we played have been winnable games. And the cowboy brethrens out there that want to bash Tony Romo, there you go.
Keep bashing.
You want to bash Tony Romo, you go. Because you see, Tony Romo makes it happen. We would be able to win at least probably all of those games except for the Patriots game. Right. We would have been at least probably in that Patriots game, but we would have won the rest of those games. Every one of those games that we played, cowboy brethrens, we were in every one of those games. And if Romo was in that game, we would have won probably all those games with the exception of the Patriots. Probably we kept it a little bit closer with the Patriots.
Now, I will say this. Okay. Last week's game, I will have a beef with that last pass interference that was called on the Cowboy player against who's a receiver for Philadelphia. I don't remember the guy's name.
I don't.
And that gave the Eagles the really easy chip shot field goal.
Oh, yeah.
That was wrong. I will agree that was wrong because that was not pass interference.
Yeah, well, in my opinion, and that ball that last year that Dez Bryant caught was a catch, and there ain't no ways about that. That ball that Dez Bryant caught clearly was a catch, and then we would have been playing Seattle in the title game, and we would have beaten Seattle.
Now
we would have played Seattle in that title game, and we would have beaten Seattle. That's what we would have done. That would have been our Super Bowl. Last year would have been our Super Bowl.
But George, let me ask you this question. Okay. The ball did cross the plane, right? Because I didn't see that game.
You were talking to the Cowboys-Packers from last year. The ball was on the one-yard line.
It was on the
one-yard line. He stretched it out there on the plane. It could have been called a touchdown, mm-hmm. or they could have called it first and goal. Either way, it should have been either a touchdown mm-hmm. or first and goal. That's what it should have been, because that one-yard line would have made it first and goal.
Okay, so did he drop the ball on the grass?
No. The ball was still in possession.
Uh-huh.
The ball that Dez had was still in possession. We got 5 minutes left in this show. That's fine. The ball was still in possession in his ball, basically, in his hand. Mm. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now.
So we know that. The Cowboys should have won that game. Cowboys should have been in the Super Bowl last year. Cowboys would have won the Super Bowl last year. That's what should have happened.
Yeah.
Now, what are you foaming out now? I mean, you're foaming something out of your mouth?
If beggars were...
Okay.
Horses. If wishes were horses, beggars would ride.
That NFC East is still winnable.
Yeah. Yeah.
The NFC East is still winnable for the Cowboys. The Cowboys still can win the NFC East.
Anybody can still win the NFC East.
That's right.
But I don't want to see Philadelphia win. I hate them.
No, I hate them too.
Yeah.
I hope Chip Kelly loses his job and gets kicked out of Philadelphia for what he's done.
Yeah.
You know, Philadelphia is the only stadium, I think, that has its own magistrate and holding cell.
Yeah, that's right. All right. If you want to know more about Gorgeous George, if you want to feel the presence of Gorgeous George, if you want to know more about Gorgeous George, this is what's causing all this. Last week, we had a show that aired, but probably will not be on the YouTube Gorgeous George on DVD because it never got recorded. Last week's show was played for the audience week three, but it never got
all the people.
Week three, but it'll never be seen, never be aired. Didn't get, you know, wasn't recorded, and it wasn't recorded on this channel, so there was no copy, so that show like will never be seen on the Gorgeous George DVD.
You lucky people who saw it.
So this is week four. We only have 5 weeks. We only have five weeks. So actually, next week before Thanksgiving
is our farewell
last show. So no, I never say that. Last week was our last show, so it doesn't seem right before Thanksgiving, because usually we have Thanksgiving show, then we have our Christmas show.
Yeah.
So we got to put it all in one little bow next week.
Are the pretty girls
put it
be
one in one little bow
I
next
hope
week.
So.
Well, if you play your cards right, you might get a facial. She'll come in here. We'll get Rosaline in here. Rosaline will give you a facial.
Fine. You know. I'm looking forward
to
that.
Okay, that's right.
Rosalina.
Okay, and Martha. Martha too will come in here. Santa's elves. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, here's a little story about Santa Claus. It's called Santa Semen. Santa Semen knows when you've been good and knows when you've been bad. So be good for goodness sakes. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Semen's watching you through his one eye. If you want your hole filled up, well, guess what? In your stockings, Santa Semen will fill your stockings and your hole. Very good. So you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout, because I'm telling you why. Santa Semen is coming to town. Santa Semen is coming to town.
Woo! Santa Semen, I didn't know he had a Navy.
I am high in praise.
I didn't know the North Pole had a Navy.
All right, we got what, 2 minutes?
Is it two very long minutes?
Two long minutes.
Two and two.
Two and two.
Chuck Woolery. Two and two.
Two and two. Yeah. One Mona Lisa, one Leaning Tower of Pisa. Put a close up here. Put a close up. One Mona Lisa, one Leaning Tower of Pisa, and there's only one Gorgeous George.
Stop leaning like
believe
a Leaning Tower of Pisa.
Or not.
That's much better.
I am on every other channel. So you can't get rid of me. I'm on every other channel. Flip the dials. You'll see me on every other channel. Woo! Diamonds are forever. Diamonds forever.
Moaning Lisa?
He's even on a debate channel.
Yes.
I don't even know how that
I am running for president of these United States. I am making my announcement on my show that I am running for president of these United States, baby. I'm taking no prisoners. I'm taking them all out.
And you can lie with the best of them.
Yes. That's right. All right. We're going to wrap up next week's show. We're going to put in a little, we're going to make it a Thanksgiving show and a Christmas show. We're going to baste the turkey and we're going to fill those stockings up and on your sleigh. And we're going to go hip hip hooray because it is Gorgeous George. Gorgeous George is coming to town.
We're going to use the turkey baster for actually basing turkey next week.
Woo!
I feel your pain. I feel your pain, Hillary.